Greetings and welcome to the first of two introductory editions of TRC Talk, a television show presented by the Greensboro Truth and Reconciliation Commission. I'm Myra Sherd, your host. This democratically created commission is mandated to seek truth and to work for reconciliation around what happened on November the 3rd, 1979. Five people died, 10 people were wounded, and unanswered questions remain. As the work progresses, you can tune in to TRC Talk to meet the commissioners, the staff, and others associated with this history-making community process. In these first two programs, we take you back to the beginning of the commission's life, the swearing-in ceremony on Saturday, June 12, 2004. The event happened at the depot in downtown Greensboro, where more than 500 people came out to witness this historic occasion. Today, we'll hear from Reverend Bongani Finca, a member of South Africa's Truth and Reconciliation Commission. Finca traveled all the way from South Africa to bring us a message from his people. We'll also hear from representatives from our own community who brought messages of their own.
I bring you all greetings, very warm greetings. I also bring you a lot of respect and admiration and a message of congratulations, solidarity, and encouragement from South Africa. And I bring it to this occasion, which is unique, an occasion which is indeed the first of its kind in the history of our struggle to build reconciliation based on truth. As South Africans, we believe that this occasion perhaps better deserves to be referred to as one small step for man and one giant leap for mankind. To the commissioners about to be inaugurated into office, I bring a special message of support, of love, and solidarity from the members of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission of South Africa. From our esteemed chairperson, His Grace the Archbishop Desmond Tutu, who writes in his personal letter to yourselves as commissioners, and I quote, "The task of a commission such as this is to bring to light the truth in order to promote reconciliation." He continues to say, "You have the additional burden of initiating the first TRC in the US. Many will be looking to you to assess whether similar commissions might be helpful in other communities also." Let me begin my own remarks with the words I wrote in December 1995, when I stood as these commissioners will stand today and took my oath to be a commissioner in the South African Truth and Reconciliation Commission. I called my thoughts that day, "When Hope Decays." When hope decays, there is a particular stench in the air of bitterness, of strife, of holding on for dear life to things that neither heal nor help. When hope decays, there is anger that pulls down what others try to build. There is frustration with those who build, with those who dream, and with those who think. For how dare they dream and hope and think, because our hope has decayed. But when hope is reborn, we dream the dreams which others scorn, We sing the songs of birds that fly. We embrace our past with all its shame and say to it, you too belong to us. We hope, we dream, we think, because our hope is reborn. We, as the South African Truth and Reconciliation Commission, are humbled and honored that the Greensboro Truth and Reconciliation Commission has been established using the model of South Africa. As we think of that model, we pay tribute to Nelson Mandela, who became the author and the pioneer of that model. As you will remember, he emerged out of prison, having spent 27 best years of his life crushing stones and confined in cells. But he emerged with a message which was later adopted as a preamble to our Constitution. And I quote from that preamble. We need to find understanding, but not vengeance. We need to find reparation, but not retaliation. We need to find ubuntu, but not victimization. These are the pillars of the route you have chosen to deal with the shame of November 3, 1979, 11 hours 23, at the corner of Carver and Everett Street. You have awakened, as we did, to the truth that bygones will not be bygones until they are confronted honestly, truthfully, and responsibly addressed. You have realized, as we did, that the tears on the eyes of those who were victimized will not be dry. No amount of ignoring those tears will make them dry. They will only be dry when we stop and face them and confront our shame and dry them. You have found, as we did, that the truth must be told, that the record must be set straight, that forgiveness must be asked for and pardon must be given before we can move together as communities and as nations. You have learned, as we did, that our past will continue to haunt our present until we agree to face that past with all its shame and address it. So, people of Greensboro, we as South Africans, we salute you. We do not wish you success because you have already succeeded. The installation today of this commission in the U.S. soil, the first of its kind, is a victory beyond words. Truth has won over lies. Memory has won over amnesia. Understanding has won over revenge. But as you take this step today, and as you travel together on this road for the next 18 months, we assure you that it will be a long walk for your commissioners. We urge you, be gentle with them. Be firm in your demand for the truth, but be kind to one another. In our language, we have a saying that a person is a person because of other persons. In that saying, we recognize that a person is not complete until she embraces other persons and struggles to make them complete also. We recognize that a person cannot be fulfilled until she finds fulfillment for others also. we recognize that we cannot have real peace until we move in isolation and find peace for those on our side and for those who live on the other side. But Ubuntu goes further than that. It says if you appear a bit taller than others who stand with you, it is not because you are really taller than them, but it is because others are carrying you in their shoulders. For this commission to fulfill its mandate and to do the task that you have set for it to do, we urge you, as the community of Greensboro, to carry the commissioners on your shoulders, to support them, to encourage them, to be with them, and to pray fervently for them. It is the first of its kind in the U.S. It must set a model that must succeed. If it does succeed, it will give us all hope that one day there will be truth commissions on Iraq, that there will be truth commissions on Ireland, that there will be truth commissions on the Middle East. If it succeeds as it must, it will give us hope that one day we will know the truth of Rwanda, and know the truth of Burundi, and know the truth of Angola. If it succeeds as it must, it will give us all hope that one day we will know the truth on neighborhoods and ghettos, on villages and towns and cities, where the blood of the innocent has been spilled and the cloud of silence has hovered over the national shame. Today, I am proud to be South African, but today I am also proud to be a little tiny part of Greensboro. We salute you. We praise you. We thank you. We will travel with you until the dream of realizing the truth is realized, because there is no alternative to truth. For us to be healed, we need it. So let truth reign. I do thank you.
Like to say, as a fellow commissioner of a different kind, congratulations. Being a commissioner can mean a lot of things to a lot of people. Lots of meetings, lots of long hours. I liken it to being a father, which I'm a newly father. You'll have to deal with people who are divided. You have to deal with information that's complex. Yeah, it'll be long hours. It'll be lots of care. Hopefully, it will not be lots of poop. This community is here, is supporting you, and I'm blessed to be here today because 24 years ago in a small town called Burgall, North Carolina, I saw the events unfold on November the 3rd, 1979, and I'm here today as a county commissioner in full support of this effort. And my hope is that you will hang in there and you will take on the full burden and responsibility of this endeavor, and that you will help us, not only the seven of you, but those of you who are in here and the citizens of Greensboro and Guilford County, that we can make this city something that it's not and that it's seeking to be coming in the future. And that is a great city, a city that listens and learns from its past and works together to shape its future. And that's what I believe is the full meaning and intent of this effort. And so I'm glad to be here, glad to be a part of this effort. Good luck, and God bless every one of you.
It is an honor to bring very warm greetings of peace and love from the city of Greensboro. For a city cannot be healthy if its citizens are not healthy. A city cannot be healed if its citizens do not seek healing. A city cannot be authentic and honest if it does not embrace and seek the truth. A city cannot be sensitive and really great if it does not know how to forgive. The mission of this commission is important and necessary. May God provide this commission with the will, the insight, the vision, the sensitivity, and caring to be that catalyst for truth, healing, and restorative justice in this community. What a blessed day.
Congratulations, commissioners. The citizens of East Greensboro were directly impacted by the tragedy of November 3rd, 1979, because it happened on our side of town, and it happened in one of our East Greensboro communities. Some of our friends, neighbors, and families were traumatized, and their lives were changed forever. But in reality, every citizen and every neighborhood in Greensboro was impacted by the tragedy. As commissioners, you will seek the truth, which will affect every citizen in every neighborhood. You'll seek the truth that will set us free, free from the guilt, free from the hurt. And we thank you for accepting the challenge to confront the issues of the past to change our future. Thank you for agreeing to serve. May God bless you in your endeavors to seek the truth to heal our great city.
Hello, we are the founders of the Territory Teen Association, a youth education and performance arts center. I am the president of the first civil rights club at Smith High School, and my sister is the vice president. I also serve as the secretary of the NAACP Youth Council of Greensboro. We are honored to bring greetings and represent the youth of Greensboro, North Carolina. We recognize the need for the Truth and Reconciliation Commission. We understand the importance of this great commission. Our mother, Portia Shipman, was a member of the CWP 1979 through 1990. The youth today are aware of the history of slavery and Jim Crow. We are aware of the history of Martin Luther King Jr. and Rosa Parks. We are aware of the Holocaust. Not to mention, we are aware of September 11, 2001. However, we are not aware of the history in our own city and communities. We lack knowledge about February 1st, the sit-in movement downtown that took place in our very own city that opened many doors against segregation. We lack knowledge about the events of the murders of November 3rd, 1979. As young individuals in this changing society, we hold the responsibility as future leaders to help our community stay positive. We believe in order for us to accomplish and follow through with that responsibility, we must be well informed as well as educated. So we want to thank all of those who helped to make this commission possible and all of the dedicated and devoted supporters.
The Truth and Reconciliation Commission is very necessary and appreciated.
Thank you.
Good morning. It is an honor to stand with my colleague this morning representing the larger faith community of Greensboro and offering my prayerful support to this esteemed commission. Freedom and liberty have long been core values integral to the formation and shaping of this nation. Political and social structures have evolved at enormous cost to human life in an effort to ensure that generations present and future would thrive in an arena of freedom. Ultimately, however, political structures provide no guarantee that the liberties of all will be held in sacred trust. Freedom will continue to be tested in our society from generation to generation. This raises the important question, how can any people strive beyond institutional structures to protect the dream of liberty? Those of us within the Christian tradition believe that Jesus spoke prophetically to this question, saying to his disciples, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." So it is, the emergence of truth remains our surest hope that freedom be secured. Whenever personal or communal freedom is challenged, the pursuit and discovery of truth becomes a divine gift that transforms life. The history of religious faith includes this important footnote, that truth is neither simple nor quickly acquired. Nonetheless, those who seek will find, and they shall know the truth, and the truth will set them free. May God bless you and the work that is set before you. May God prepare all of our hearts for truth and reconciliation. Thank you.
To those who have worked hard to convene this event today, to those who will be serving over the next few months on this commission, and to all of you who have come this day to make this an important and historic event, I say to you that the Greensboro Pulpit Forum, African-American clergy that exists in this community, is very happy to be a part of this event. Today we meet at the seating of a commission to seek truth about a community tragedy in hopes of reconciling our community to itself. Our model is similar to the one in South Africa, which was seated in the midst of a transition of power. No such transition of power is the impetus for our event, and yet our connection is the sharing of a history of oppression and the exploitation of a poor and helpless community. Among us today are some of the parties that are necessary to ferret out the truth that you will be seeking. The names of our conveners include those who lived in Morningside, and God has heard them ask the question, why was our community chosen to be the site of this horrible tragedy? Among us today are some of the survivors and those who suffered great losses of friends and family. Among us today are those who chose the date and time, those who stood aside, some cursing and some cheering. Morningside has died, and this commission is left here to perform a postmortem of her death and to inform this community of its results in a manner that will reconcile us to each other. Your only tool will be the truth. Time and history will judge your work on the truth you uncover, not whether you satisfy the desires of those of us today, not whether you make glad the hearts of your detractors, not whether you and your fellow travelers will be able to say, did not the words of the commission make our hearts glad, but what truth did we uncover that can be a tool to reconcile this community? And will your work join the hands of Marty Nathan, the children of Marty Nathan, to the hands of the man who shot their father? Will the work you do reconcile Morningside community to the rest of this community and to the world? Will your work reconcile all of us? On number 3rd, Morningside Home was changed from poor and a proud community of African Americans struggling to make life better for themselves and their posterity into a cancer so deadly that it threatened to destroy the body of the people it originally nurtured. And now it's up to you. And it's appropriate that you have asked me to stand on behalf of the Pulpit Forum and the community of prophets in this community, and there are some present today. I saw members of the forum. Well, members of the forum who are here today, please stand. I saw some coming in as I was coming in. I saw Brother McMurray. Did I see? Yes. Members of, yes, thank you. Reverend Dr. Curtis Brown. Amen. We are here because truth is our job, and the kind of prophecy that will come out of this commission is our job as well. It is the role of the prophet to point a finger in the face of the powerful and to speak truth. I've come today to add the voice of the prophet to the voice of the celebrants. truth crushed to the earth will keep coming back. There is no need for the community to continue to ask the question, why is this coming up over and over again? Truth crushed to the earth will rise again, and it will continue to seek its place. Truth will rise above funding, above community, above conspiracies, and above collusions. And when truth is heard, all will know it. Truth is its own footnote. And this is my role today. It's a role that the Pulpit Forum has played in this community for as long as it has existed. And my brothers and sisters, when truth comes, all will respond. Seekers will moan and come confessing. Those who deny truth will rise up boisterous and angry. Those who want truth will be awed and amazed and filled with joy and a new spirit, and those who crush truth will be defeated, but not silenced. Yet all will be affected. The spirit of reconciliation must be a deliberate follow-up of this work. And throughout the period of truth-seeking you will be engaged in, it must be a planned event, and in every telling of the truth, the concomitant method of reconciliation must be sought and built in. The Pulpit Forum supports the work of this commission. It is our belief that we must harmonize the gospel and celebrate Zion in these times. And to that end, we greet you, we support you, and we welcome you in the words of the old church fathers, to the bitters and to the sweets.
In case you've just tuned in, you've been watching TRC Talk on Greensboro Community Television. If you want more information or want to get involved with the Greensboro Truth and Reconciliation Commission, please visit www.greensborotrc.org or call us at 336-275-6462. We also welcome your feedback on the show, which is a work in progress. Please send your comments and questions to TRC Talk at greensborotrc.org.